Next question. In Jelinek's method of estimation of nitrogen in organic compound, nitrogen is A. liberated as free nitrogen, converted into ammonium sulfate, first converted into ammonium sulfate and then into ammonia. This is a very interesting question. Because when we study the estimation by Jelinek's method, so actually what is happening, we are taking Jelinek's flask and we are taking a known quantity of organic substance and we are adding a non-sulfuric acid, potassium sulfate and the correspondingly copper sulfate. And we are heating strongly. When we are heating strongly, sulfuric acid will convert this into ammonium sulfate, first step. Then we are transferring this ammonium sulfate quantitatively in a Jelinek flask connected to a Liebig condenser, that is a condenser. Then after adding sodium hydroxide, if you boil, ammonia will be liberated. And the liberated ammonia we are passing into a known standard volume of the strength of an acid where ammonia will be consumed. From the ammonia consumed, then and the unreacted, from the unreacted acid, we can estimate the percentage of the amount of volume of ammonia consumed. From that we can determine the percentage. So the answer should be first converted into ammonium sulfate and then ammonia. So this is the flask we are using first step. This is the flask we are using for second step. So now see here, organic compound containing that is our nitrogen. When you are using non-sulfuric acid in presence of potassium sulfate and copper sulfate in Jelinek flask, converted into ammonium sulfate, first step, step one. Then we are transferring quantity into a Jelinek flask and adding sodium hydroxide, boiling, ammonia is liberated. This ammonia we are titrating against let us say 0.1 N sulfuric acid by taking an 100 ml. Let us say. So suppose 50 ml is consumed, means only remaining 50 ml we have to determine how much by titrating against sodium hydroxide taken in here as a burette. From that amount of ammonia consumed we know, from the volume we have to calculate. That is the method we are following. So the answer here it is, first converted into ammonium sulfate and then into ammonia.